Providing students with the knowledge and skills necessary to succeed in a rapidly changing world is the key to their success. STEAM, or Science, Technology, Engineering, Arts, and Math, is a modern approach to that, focusing on valuing the learning process as much as the results.
Mountain View School is incorporating STEAM education in its curriculum across the school day to basically increase innovative learning opportunities for students across all grade levels.
STEAM is basically the bringing together of many different content areas that traditionally have been siloed and separated in the hope that it'll provide a better educational context or a better context for kids to learn all of the different disciplines. They'll see the interconnections between science and math, and between engineering and math, between technology and science and technology and math. And they've added the A in there, actually, which is an important piece. The A is for art, so it's now not STEM, it's STEAM. So to add to what's normally a mechanical kind of set of disciplines, that piece that can interconnect, that can allow for a lot more different types of learners to engage in that whole line of learning.
The school has incorporated design thinking and the Stanford design process into the STEAM education to provide a solution-based approach to solving problems.
It allows our kids to take a bigger ownership in the problem-solving process. It's not spoon-feeding or memorizing countless facts. It truly is taking and looking at something and trying to find out the answers why.
I like experiencing stuff on my own and learning how to do it, because if someone tells me how to do it or gives me the answer, then I'm not going to learn. I want to learn how to do it so that I'm not struggling when someone, because if someone's not there to tell me the answer, then I'm just going to be struggling.
No matter what job they go to when they graduate, we want kids to be in that area where there's no right or wrong answer and there's no way to do it, and to be able to work through that, to problem solve through that, to use critical thinking. That's where all of these things could come together in that messy process.
We want them to fail, and we don't mean that get an F, but we mean that when you make a mistake, it's good, because then you can say, okay, that didn't work out. What could I do differently? And then engaging them in that process and in that thinking, and then even discussing it with the class. What went well? What didn't?
They are coming across problems that they didn't anticipate, and then having that opportunity to do that trial and error and, okay, this isn't working, so we need to go this route, and let's try this, and if that doesn't work, even trying yet again. And that growth mindset piece is very much built into all of this in the process they go through.
Do my students need to be able to have test-taking skills? Absolutely. But they also need to be 21st century thinkers, which means thinking out of the box.
Mountain View has partnered with Shadow Ridge High School to help bring some of the engineering, architecture, and digital media career and technical education programs to the students.
And they're basically trying to set up a means for those programs to sort of find their way into a low stakes, kind of fun way for kids to explore. If you look at the statistics across the country, not a lot of women go into the engineering fields. And the hope here is that through the iExplore Lab, they can set up a kind of playground where they can sort of get their feet wet with some of these things and realize it's not as intimidating as it should be. Maybe this is something I want to go into. And with the need that there is for girls to go into STEM, maybe it could be that piece that's going to make them decide to go that direction and to fill that huge gap.
Mountain View has also partnered with MACISA, or the Maricopa County Education Service Agency, and the 21st Century Specialists in the district to ensure staff get the professional development training they need to be successful.
Our school's been blessed in having an opportunity to work with MACISA and go through STEM leadership programs and trainings with them, to learn from them, to draw from them, and bring resources in that help us better prepare our students for the world that's out there.
One of the problems that most teachers have is, how do I take what I normally have taught in silos and take it out of silos and put it together into something that's more meaningful? How do I attach it to the real world? And a lot of teachers have a little bit more trouble with that, but what we're seeing is where they're doing it and they're experimenting with it, they're having success and they're really enjoying that success, and they're seeing the kids have a great time with it, and they're seeing the learning be a lot more meaningful for the students.
Daring students to be wrong, to listen to the opinions of other students, to try many different ideas and create solutions based on real life is the foundation for the STEAM educational approach at Mountain View School.
It makes the students more want to do like science and technology, so that when they're older, they're smarter, they know what stuff to do. And I think that's a great thing because then kids, they grow up learning what coding is, what engineering is.
They literally are more engaged in their learning. They're excited about it. They love the idea of being able to support the world in a more positive way as well.
I don't want to teach my kids to think the way I think. I want them to think for themselves. I want them to learn for themselves. Do I guide them? Do I give them the resources? Do I pose them a question and make them figure out their answers for themselves? Absolutely. That's what good education and good learning does.